Hello everyone, in this video we're going to take a look at how you can update your Medusa 2.0 dependencies. The Medusa core team is releasing updates all the time, and these updates include a lot of nice new features and also a lot of bug fixes. And you probably want to stay up to date with your dependencies. I have a Medusa 2.0 project right here that I started a few weeks ago, and last time I updated it to the version 2.0.5, and since then there have been quite a few releases and I want to update it again. The overview where you can see the current versions is the GitHub of medusa.js/medusa/releases. I'll make sure to put a link to this page. And if we are going to scroll through the page here, we can see that this one we can ignore safely because it's not related to the Medusa 2.0. This is a Medusa 1.0. But I can scroll a little bit further and I can see here that we will have so here is a 2.0 preview version. This is the 0.6. And so there's already one version newer, but if I scroll further, I can see that there is also a 0.7 and all the way to the top. And there is also a 0.8. So I'm three versions behind. And these three versions, what I noticed is that they have this breaking change in them, and that means that when updating there is a chance that something will go wrong that I have to sort out. So if I'm using some of the features that have breaking changes, then the update will not go as smoothly and I'll have to do a little bit of tinkering to get it to work. But let's see how bad it actually is when we get to the actual update. So all of them has a breaking change, and I might be using this one, but I think that all the other ones something that I am not using. So maybe if we're lucky, this will be an easy one. Let's go back to our project, and I am in VS Code and I have a terminal open in my backend. And I also have the package.json open here, and I want to show you that all the dependencies, they just have this preview flag because this is a Medusa 2.0 project and the major of the 2.0 is just called preview. And inside the package log.json file, this is a very large file, and this one lists the exact version of your dependencies. So here is the exact versions that will be installed when you install npm, and this is what is outdated. These are from the 2.0.5 release, and I want to get the newest ones. So a nice command to use is npm outdated, and make sure to be in your backend directory when you want, right? I'll hit enter and it takes a while. And we can indeed see that there's a lot of things that have been outdated. So all of these at Medusa are the Medusa dependencies, and we can see that the current version and the wanted version doesn't match. So these ones are newer. And if we go back to the release page here, there's actually a little instruction on how you update it. So it's asked you to remove the nodes module folder, so that's all the dependencies, and then the yarn log or package log file. And in this project, which comes from my boilerplate, monorepository boilerplate from Railway, we're using the package log file here. So we need to delete that, and we need to delete the node modules folder. Then we are on a clean slate where everything is just called preview. So let's do that. So I'll say rm false node modules and also package log, hit enter, and then I'll delete it. And what we next need to do is just install dependencies again. And the reason why we are then updating is because then the package manager is just defaulting to preview because it doesn't have the exact versions from the package log anymore. And then it will just automatically take the latest version of the preview, and then it will also create the package log.json and write into that the exact version that it installed. So let's do that. npm I. And this is going to take a while, so I'm going to pause the video and come back when the installation has completed. All right, the installation of dependencies has now completed, and you can see that we again now have a package log.json file, and we also have node modules again. Let's try to run the outdated command. And we can see all the versions numbers now match, so we are on the latest versions, which is what we wanted. Okay, let's see if the project is still working or if anything broke. So I will try to build npm run build. All right, the build is now completed and I did not get any errors, which is the first good sign. Let's try to run the backend. npm run start. Okay, looks like the backend is up and running. Let's try to log in and see. So localhost 9000, I'll give it a refresh. And the app is starting, which is a good sign. I'll get my credentials, email, and my password. All right, we are now in and everything is loading beautifully. That means we successfully have updated our dependencies. Now we want to publish the update. So I'll say I'm in the root of the monorepository. I'll do a git status and I will see that in the backend we have the package log.json. That is the file we want to add. That's the one we updated. So git add backend package log.json. And git commit updated to 2.0.8. So we know next time that we are going to update that we remember we left at 2.0.8. Hit enter. Git push. All right, we have now published our update. I'll head back to Railway to see that our update is being published. And I just entered my project and I can see it started building. So let's open the backend and we can see updated to 2.0.8. And if we head over to our repository, we can indeed see there was an update in the backend and it is the package log.json file a minute ago. That is good news. Let's close down this one and head back to Railway. I'll pause the video and start it again as soon as the deploy has finished. All right, the changes have now been deployed and we have a green check mark. Let's just verify that the site is up and running. So we go to our backend URL and we need to add slash app. And I'm already logged in and everything looks fine. So I think we can safely conclude that we have successfully updated the dependencies manually. If you found this video just by searching and you're wondering how I have all this set up on Railway hosted in the cloud with automated deploy pipeline and everything, you can get the same. It's very easy. I have this blog post that I'll make sure to leave a link to, and I'm actively maintaining this blog post. It comes with a video guide how you set it up, but it is more easy than you might think. If you scroll a little bit down, you'll find this deploy on Railway button. And this is a deploy template that you'll just have to click this button. You obviously have to be signed up with Railway, and you also need to be on the hobby user subscription plan, which is $5 per month. But once you click this button, you will just have this stack hosted on Railway with the automated deploy pipeline and everything set up, just working out of the box. I'm actively maintaining the blog post and this deploy template. So this one is now updated to version 2.0.8, which is the latest right now, and I'll update it as long as a fair amount of people is engaging with this project. And once you have that up and running, if you didn't already have it, then you can scroll down and here is a section called self-help, and there you will get guides on how to continue with your project. There is how you can set it up locally. I have links to a few other videos from other content creators where they explain how to add different features. Here is a guide also including a video on how you set up credit card payment with Stripe, and now you also know how to update your dependencies manually going forward. All right, that concludes this video. I hope that helped you. Have a nice day.